All right. Got a lot to tell you in a short time to tell you. We delivered our load a day early. In Laverne, Tennessee. So, jumped on the load board. Found a load picking up in Mount Vernon. Going back down close to Atlanta. So we're loading it right now. And we're gonna start heading that way. Deliver there tomorrow by 2 o'clock. Yeah. Got the old Blue Star. Truck definitely needs washing. Duck man's out here running around doing hit business. So Ducky took care of hit business. Old country boy took care of hit business back over. I think he's done loading me. I heard loading dock moving. All right, I gotta go get in the truck. Gotta go sign my paperwork and get out of here. Get the duck man put back in the truck. And we're gonna try to book it down to Hopkinsville, Kentucky before we run out of hours. We're up in Mount Vernon right now. So we'll try to get down there, do us a 10-hour break, and then book it on down to Atlanta. Get this load off tomorrow and book it back up to Chattanooga to pick up. Come on, Dad, we gotta go, buddy. Come on, buddy. All right, Dad, let's go. I just thought I would show y'all where we're picking up at, or where we're leaving out from. Yeah, this doesn't look like the typical place where you would pick up, does it? Man. Yeah, we definitely back up in a residential area, man. Look how little these roads are. Woo! Some narrow little roads, man. Yeah. You don't normally go back in places where roads are this little. Woo! Oh man, look at that shoulder, boy. Damn, boy, just a little too close and you're gonna drop right off. Damn! Woo. Let me get up out of here. Damn. I wonder what was here first, the houses or the plant where I picked up at back there. We'll listen to it and see what it says. Maybe it works. I don't see no truck signs here. We definitely residential driving, buddy. Ain't no lying about that. We are residential driving. Woo. I wonder how they even paved this road with all that drop off like that on each side, man. That's crazy. But we're in Mount Vernon, Indiana. We had booked a load picking up in Evansville, and I get about halfway up here, and the guy says, hey, they don't want to ship it today. They want to wait till tomorrow. And I'm like, that won't work. I already got a load scheduled for tomorrow. I need one for today. So they got me. I called another agent and got this load here. So make an extra after Landstar takes this cut, we'll get about an extra $800 for one day work. Ah, screw it. You just gotta go sometimes, right? But yeah, we get an extra $800 for that one day of work. That's not too bad. You know, I try to make between 900 or better a day. You know, and then at the end of the week, you know, 4,500. And then you subtract your fuel. You know, you're making a decent paycheck. I know there's a lot of people talking about
fuel mileage and your overhead and this and that. I'm a simple guy. I like to keep it. I believe in the KISS program. Keep it simple, stupid. As Chocolate Myers would say, the KISS program. Keep it simple, stupid. All right, here's my simple philosophy. You got to make this much money per day, you know. But at the same time, you got it in the back of your mind that even though you're making this much a day, you can't say, okay, I'm gonna make $900 a day, and go out and spend $700 to make $900, because then you ain't done nothing. So I don't agree to that philosophy, but you know, your cost is what your cost is, right? So everybody has different ways of figuring it up, but I'm kind of a trial and error kind of guy, you know? Like, I run, I see how much money I make this week. If it pays my bills, I'm like, okay, so I need to keep doing that or better every week. Okay, there you go. You know what the bar is now. You set the bar, you know what it is, and you go from there. That's the way I do it. I keep track of all my receipts. You know, everything from fuel to water to you name it. I keep receipts on everything. And so, because I try to write everything off I can on my taxes at the end of the year. But you can't be out here stressing, man. You gotta figure out a groove that works and then just work that groove. You know what I'm saying? Know what I'm saying? But you can't stress over the simple things, you know. A lot of people say, well, you know, if I know all the numbers, you know, it makes me feel good about myself and it's less stressful. Well, look at the other side of that coin. Suppose you know what your numbers are and your numbers are bad and they're not good. Then you're gonna feel bad, you know? You're not gonna feel good. But I understand the other side of it too. Then if you find out your numbers are bad, you need to make adjustments. And I agree on that 100%. But like I said, you just gotta figure out a groove that works for you, because what works for one may not work for the other. And I found my groove that works for me. You know, I bought my first truck back in 2012. So I'm relatively new to the owner-operator game. But like I said, I've been driving for decades. But I'm new to the owner-operator game. You know, I've only been doing it for, you know, since 2012. So I'm still learning out here too. But during that time, I found a groove that works for me, you know. And I'll be honest with you, the one thing that keeps me sane and keeps me in that good groove is my support system at home, my wife. Because she helps me out. She makes a good living, and her income combined with mine takes a lot of pressure off of me. You know, everybody isn't in that position. I'm fortunate to be in that position. That's why I don't have to stress over the numbers, because I have a fail-safe. You know, I have another source of income coming in that helps me out, that takes some of that pressure off of me. So I'm lucky with that. So anyway, let's get our butt on back down to where we headed to, Rob. Oh, we going down. Let's get on down to Hopkinsville. What you say? Oh, hell, we may even get on down to Oak Grove. Who knows? Yeah. Hit up the pilot or the Flying J and get some bean the cup. All right. Let's go. I don't know if y'all can see. There's the duck man. There he is. There's the duck man. What you doing, duck duck? Look at all the space he's got, man. Hey, to my good buddy, my acquaintance, whatever he is, Daniel Mr. Adami. Oh, hell, it went dark. There it was. Okay. Check it out, brother. all this space. Was look at all this space, man. Ain't nothing around here. Building way over yonder. You wouldn't even have to put your dog on a leash.
You could do like I do with Ducky, go leashless. Yeah. Trying to brighten it up, but it won't brighten up. But it's still brighten up. Anyway, but you can, because you got three dogs, man. You cut them loose out here, man, they'd be having a ball, man. Maybe having some fun. Oh, there comes the duck, man. Where's he at? Where's he at? There he goes. Over there by the tree line. So anyway, something to think about. I mean, I know truck stops are good for you. And some truck stops are good for dogs. But I like to look for places that out of the way like this one. It's not a truck stop. It's not super convenient for me, but it's good for the duck, man, because he's got a lot of room to run around and play. So I'm letting him run right now and play for a good 30 minutes, get worked out good. And then before we leave in the morning around 5, I'll probably run him again. So he'll sleep most of the day tomorrow. All right, y'all don't go nowhere. We're going to jump back in the truck, warm up. It's getting cold out here. Yeah. All right. Oh, yeah, there's the duck, man. Tearing it up. Tearing it up, duck. Tearing it up. There you go. We're at the Loves just before you get to the 285 loop outside of Atlanta on I-75. I wanted to stop when we first started coming into Georgia, and I missed the that first rest area coming into Georgia, and then I was going to get that other one down there close to south of Dalton. There he is, he's way back over here. But I was kind of trapped in that center lane. I couldn't get over. So I didn't want to stop at the TA in Cartersville. It sucks. Dad, come on, buddy. So we ended up here at the Loves. They got this big grassy area back here, all around out in here, for the duck man to roam around. You can see we're parked right there. So he didn't have that far to go. What? So anyway, we're less than an hour from where we got to deliver. So we're gonna try to jump down there, get delivered no later than 1 o'clock, because I think we have until 2. But we're gonna get in there as quick as we can, get delivered, and see if we can't get our butt back up north of Chattanooga where we got to pick up at. And I don't know. I don't know how far we'll go south. We may come back down to Cartersville and spend a night there, or do a 10-hour break there, then leave out and head on down to Ocala. So we'll just have to wait and see. Anyway, come on along with us. I'll show y'all where we're delivering at. Let's go. All right, so we just checked in at receiving right there at the door. Look at all the woods back there. Pine trees too. Pine straw and all kind of good stuff. So we're gonna go over here. We're gonna back in over there where it says receiving. And then we're gonna let the duck man out. Let him run around a little bit more, cause I don't think he got it all out of his system up there at the other place. I think he's still wired up. Yeah. Oh, I see him now. Oh, he jumped over my seat. You can't get in my seat, you can't drive. But look, there's some more grass right there. So, yeah, we'll let him out, run around some more. There's some more woods over there. I see you in my seat. You're in my seat. I always pick at him. You're in my seat. You can't drag. Get my seat. He's a mess. So, we're going to slide our tandems. Oh, yeah. We're getting rid of this trailer. And we're getting another old trailer. So this one is a 692, and we're getting rid of it and getting a 698. So anyway, I just wanna let y'all know we made it here, and I'll put a picture in here so you can see what we're hauling. And yeah, I'll go ahead and show you. Hell, probably won't take me that long. I'll put you right there so y'all can see me. All right. There we go. All right. Had brick seal. All right.
So, that's what we're hauling. Low to the ground, ain't it? Yeah.
All right. So, thank y'all so much for watching, liking, subscribing. We're going to leave here, boop, up to Chattanooga, and we'll touch in with y'all when we get up that way. So, thank y'all so much. Leave me a comment. Let me know what you think. And we'll be talking to y'all soon. All right. Day's Friday. Weekend. Woo! All right. Don't forget our motto. If you're an owner operator, don't haul no cheap freight. All right. Peace.